This video will show you how to install your SmartBoard QX V2 Pro Series interactive display. The installation of all SmartBoard displays is similar, with minor variations by model and size. In this video, we'll demonstrate the process by installing a 65-inch display on a wall. Be sure to refer to the installation instructions for your specific display model. The illustrated installation instructions are included in the display's packaging, and you can also download them from Smart's support site. To learn about installing the display on a stand rather than on a wall, visit Stands and Wall Mounts on Smart's support site. Remove the accessories from the accessory slot on the side of the packaging and set them aside for use later. The package indicates which side is the front of the display. Because you need to attach brackets to the back of the display before you mount it to the wall, make sure that you have clear access to the back of the display and that the back is oriented toward the mounting location. Cut and remove the packaging strips, and remove any loose packaging pieces. Carefully lift the top of the packaging to remove it. Be sure to remove both the cardboard and foam packing materials. The accessories box contains a variety of important accessories for the display, such as Wi-Fi antennas, pens, and the remote control. It's a good idea to keep all the accessories in one place, so you can find them easily as you install the display. QX V2 Pro Series displays also include a smart bolt-on camera in a separate box. Make sure you have this camera available during the installation. Carefully cut the protective bag and pull it down. Attach the smart bolt-on camera to the top of the display and connect its USB-C cable to the camera port near the top of the display. If you'll be using an optional smart OPS-PC module, now's a good time to install it in the display's OPS slot before you mount the display to the wall or connect power. We'll install the display on a wall using smart wall mount model WM-SBID-200. This wall mount kit includes the wall mount, two brackets for the display, four screws for mounting those brackets to the display, and an illustrated installation guide. The wall mount installation guide is also available on the Smart support site. The installation guide shows the additional hardware and tools that aren't included but that you might need. Be sure to have those available before you begin the installation. Before you install the wall mount, consider the type of installation and the average height of the people who will use the display. Also, make sure there's enough wall space to accommodate the display and include space around the display to allow for airflow, cable access, and to let you adjust the display's position. Secure the wall mount to the wall using appropriate fasteners for the type of wall. Make sure the display's bracket security screw is loose enough to permit mounting the display on the wall mount without obstruction. Secure the two brackets to the back of the display using M8 screws, four of which are included with the wall mount. In most cases, there's a range of bracket installation heights you can choose from. Select a height that allows clear access for the lower screw heads. Using two or more people as needed for the display's weight and size, lift the display out of its packaging and carefully hang it on the mount. Secure the display brackets to the mount to minimize risk of accidental removal. You might need to use a long-reach screwdriver for this step. Don't tighten these screws fully. Turn them only until they stop. Attach the Wi-Fi antennas to the bottom of the display. Connect the display's power cable from the power outlet to the display's power input port, but don't turn the display on quite yet. If you're using a wired Ethernet network connection, attach the network cable from your network to the display. If you're connecting an external computer, attach the computer's video and USB data cables to the display. After everything is connected, find the main power switch on the back of the display and turn it on. The location of this switch varies by display model and size, but it's usually close to where the power cable is connected. If the display doesn't begin to turn on automatically, press the power button on the front. Put batteries in the remote control. Put the pens in the display's pen tray. After you turn on the display for the first time, you're prompted with some setup screens. Follow the on-screen instructions to set up the display's language, identifying name, country, smart service region, Wi-Fi network connection, and other options. Smart's IQ4 system software runs on a Google Android operating system with Google Play services. When you're asked if you want to copy apps and data from a previous Android device, select Don't Copy. When prompted to sign in with a Google account, remember that this sign-on is for the display owner account, and anyone who uses this display will be able to access it. We suggest you skip this because users can sign into their own accounts after the display is set up. Select the optional Google services you want to accept, and then tap Accept. When prompted to create a PIN, remember that this PIN is for the lock screen for the display owner account. If this PIN is lost or forgotten, you won't be able to unlock and use the display. We suggest you skip this. Users can sign into and set up a PIN for their own account's lock screen after the display has been set up. If your organization uses Smart Remote Management, go to Apps, Smart Remote Management, enter your organization's account name, accept the terms and conditions, and select Enroll. After the initial setup, it's important to check for display software updates. Go to Settings, System, Update, and tap the Check for Updates button. Install smart product drivers on any computers you've connected to the display. You can download smart product drivers from Smart's support website. Smart product drivers is available on its own, and it's also included with Smart's education and business software packages, such as Smart Notebook, Smart Meeting Pro, and Smart Teamworks. For product documentation, troubleshooting, and support, scan the QR code on the side of the display or visit support.smarttech.com. If you'd like to see more videos like this, subscribe to the Smart Support YouTube channel and visit smarttech.com. Thanks for watching.